capital. It's a little breezy today, but it's sunny and warm. So we're going to take an opportunity to practice this amazing Kriya called the Ajna Chakra Stimulation Kriya. So Ajna Chakra, this is the pituitary gland. So the pituitary gland is the master gland. It'll help fine-tune this gland. And with the master gland fine-tuned, it'll help bring or restore balance to the glandular system throughout the body. As always, we tune in by chanting the Adi Mantra and the Mangalacharan Mantra. Sitting straight, spine straight, chin is gently tucked in, and light neck locked close to the eyes, taking in a long breath. Exhale. Inhale, rubbing the palms together. Exhale. Hands in prayer pose, thumbs to the sternum. Inhale to chant. Om Namo. Aad Guray Nameh, Aad Guray Nameh, Siri Gurudev Nameh, Aad Guray Nameh, Jugaad Guray Nameh, Aad Guray Nameh, Siri Gurudev Nameh, Aad Guray Nameh, Jugaad Guray Nameh, Aad Guray Nameh, Siri Gurudev Nameh. Inhale, suspend the breath.
More into the frame, so you get a little higher and a little wider. And the app that I'm using is FiLMiC Pro. And if ever you want to do some research, a little bit of history on the Moondog Labs anamorphic lens, it was used to film a movie called Tangerine using an iPhone 5. Apparently the director said it was a tough experience, a challenging experience, but the quality was amazing. I've worked on film sets and I've seen these anamorphic lenses and they're like $75,000 and up. And this one you can acquire from Moondog Labs for about $175 US. So, and still get the same anamorphic properties and qualities that the $75,000 lens will provide. So, if you're an iPhoneographer and you're looking to enhance your filming experience, this will give you more of a cinematography or cinematic look, a widescreen look. That might be something that you'd be interested in. So, let's start off with some spinal flex. So, placing the hands on the shins. Inhale, bring the chest forward. Keeping the chin tucked in, head level with the horizon. Exhale, rock back. just take a moment. Shoulders, head and shoulders move together. So you don't want to just move the shoulders and keep the head stationary. You want to turn the head with the shoulder. Inhale to the left, exhale to the right. Center, suspending the breath, exhale, relax, so for our final warm-up posture, we'll do the ego eradicator. So you want to fold the fingers onto the palms, extend the thumbs out, holding the arms at 60 degrees. So make sure they're not 45. So bring them up to 90, come down 30. So it's a tighter angle than we anticipate. A lot of times people go down here, and they go down here. Make sure you're holding it up a little higher. This is done with breath of fire. Close the eyes, concentrate on the crown, begin.
fingertips, stretch up, apply more bunda, traction.
Standing posture. Make those fists. And then you want to tilt the head back. And then focus with the eyes at a point fixed at the sky or at the ceiling. And we're going to do this with breath of fire. Now, if breath of fire is not accessible to you, just do long, deep breathing. Inhale deep, exhale, bring the head to center, inhale.
sure that your head, as much as possible, is aligned with your arms. Your feet are about a foot and a half apart, as well as the hands. Coming on all fours. Keep the toes in. Drive the hips up. Breathe long and deep. Posture, apply mulabandha. Contraction of the erectile sexual organs in out. Inhale, slowly come together with posture. Just take a moment here to integrate, appreciate your efforts. Flex the feet to create tension between the hands and the ankles. You want to raise the chest and raise the thighs off your mat. Breathe long and deep. Begin.
hold, stretch up, exhale, relax, just lying on your tummy. Coming into baby pose, so stretch the lower spine.
So, for the next posture, we're going to do stretch pose. It's a challenging posture. If you can't do breath of fire, breathe long and deep. This posture helps strengthen the navel chakra, the third chakra. It allows us to embrace change. When it's strong, it allows us to pray. Allow change to happen. Allows us to flow with change. And enables us to limit our resistance to change. It also gives you strength of character, and it's also very important to strengthen this area in order to open up the pineal gland, which is the seat of the soul, the mystical third eye. Alright, so, stretch pose. So lie on the back.
I bring the knees to the chest and then I extend the legs, holding the heels about 6 inches off the mat, hands over the hips, eyes are focused on the big toes. Breath of fire. Now, put one heel down and then alternate, side to side, or gently kiss both heels on the mat. Do your best. Inhale, hold. Exhale, relax.
Sit in rock pose, sitting on the heels. So what we want to do here is spinal flex, but from rock pose. So the hands are resting on the thighs. Inhale, bring the chest forward. Exhale, flex the spine backwards. Begin. Keep the head level. level with the horizon, chin gently tucked in. Inhale forward, hold the breath in the posture, exhale, relax. So this posture, we're going to come down into baby pose, a slight variation. You want to place the palms on the soles of the feet. You want to come into this posture here. You want to have the eyes closed, focusing on the third eye. So this posture helps stimulate the sixth chakra, the Ajna chakra, and it helps cleanse the eyes. I might have to do another minute or two. Anywhere from 5 to 20 minutes, so we're going to do 6 minutes. Just breathe normally and gently. Begin.
taking a long deep breath, slowly coming up.
Back and forth. final posture is meditation. We're going to do the Satnam meditation, but we're going to undulate. And it's called a seven-wave Satnam. So this helps open the heart and connect us with the primal source. So it goes like this. Both hands are in Dhyan Mudra, resting on the knees. Arms are straight but not rigid. Chin is gently tucked in. Spine is straight. Eyes are closed. So we're going to inhale deep. And we chant, Sa. Spine straight, chin is gently tucked in, a light neck lock. Hands in the Dhyan Mudra, the index fingers touching the thumbs. Inhale deep. for Shavasana. Lying on your mat, palms facing up, just letting yourselves relax completely.
elbows, bending both knees, opening up the arms, letting the knees fall to one side, turn the head to the other. Switch sides. And coming onto the back, rubbing the soles and the palms together. Tucking the knees into the chest and gently rocking back and forth.
So we'll finish off our practice with the long time sunshine song, and I also want to take this chance to wish you a happy Canada Day. It is the 1st of July, so this is a great Kriya to tune up the glandular system after a day of partying. And if, of course, we party for the whole weekend, definitely revisit this Kriya to help balance the system and the glandular system and the hormones and all that good stuff. Sitting straight, spine straight, chin is gently tucked in. Inhale, rubbing the palms together. Exhale, hands in prayer pose, thumbs to the sternum.